before the year started, I was very apprehensive about this year. I was constantly being told how hard the workload was going to be. It was going to be a huge step up from second year, and the workload in that year was very hard as well. But this year was more of a professional year. It's strange. I've been training for 8 years, and you always aspire to get to that point where you're just on the verge of breaking into your professional career. I've always knew, hopefully, it was going to happen, but because it's always in a process, you never actually feel it. It's always still ahead of you, and you think, oh, it's never going to come, it's a long journey. And you just hope for that light at the end of the tunnel. I personally have been given quite a few opportunities, and I think this has been a good thing for me. It's enabled me to mature my dancing a lot quicker than I possibly could have if I had not been given those chances. The drive and the will is still there, but that would take me through class, and class is very important. Until now, I would hold it as the most important thing for me. But now I know it's a lot more than that. There's so much I can give on stage. I've had the opportunity to do a piece called Jabula, which means joy. It's an incredibly strong piece. It's contemporary, but it's very theatrical and very moving. And I was given the opportunity to do the solo. I feel I've been able to move on fairly successfully from the whole negative, spiraling down attitude that I had in class. It was pretty detrimental, but it was a process that I had to go through to learn more about myself. If something isn't good, I'll sort of sit back and say, well, look, if it's not working, I'll just give it a rest, and then I'll go back to it in a few minutes. I think you have to be slightly negative just to keep everything in perspective. The pieces this year have been incredibly good for me. A lot of them are requiring a lot of strength. Sometimes I feel very excited. It's a whole new chapter in my life, and it's going to be incredibly exciting to live. At the same time, I'm leaving all I've ever known. I've trained since 11, and this actually is all I've known. Everything I've done in London, I've been sort of protected and looked after by the school, and it's going to be odd going into a career. I have to leave so many incredible people and friends. I mean, we're all jetting off to different parts of the world. I mean, some people are in America, some people in Germany. Yeah, it's going to be sad to see everybody go. And I don't know if I'm going to enjoy that part, actually, because sometimes I feel I need them to sort of support me and be around me. And to not have them there, it's going to be very sad, I think.
Keep your leg up there, Lee. Don't let it come over his head.
That's it. Good. And then go on. You start to get a little bit tired when you're doing all that.
Lee's performance over this past year has matured amazingly. I think he's just grown as an artist and as a person, but the experiences that he's had, I think, has made a big difference to him. Not only the experiences, but the success that he's had.
I've just been offered Scottish Ballet. Ashley Page came into class and he showed great interest, which was great. He came back and then offered me a contract if I was interested, and I told him I definitely was. It was great comfort to know that I was wanted by a company, and it was great relief. and it starts in November. Scottish Ballet is a great company. I mean, Ashley Page has done a wonderful job bringing up a fantastic reputation and choreographing fabulous repertoire for the company. So it'll be an interesting experience to do his pieces. I can't wait. I'm really excited about going there, going to a whole new city, meeting a whole different people. And yeah, it's going to be a good 6 months.
That he's got a professional contract, and the Scottish Ballet, the director is very caring and understanding. But the thing is, with a smaller company, you really have to get in there and dance. With a bigger company, you can go more slowly, you can be sort of protected, you can spend a year or two in the quarter ballet, not having to really deliver much. Whereas in a small company, you really have to get in there and you have to deliver straight away. I think he's ready for it yet. Whether he thinks that is the big thing. So, yes, this is what fate's decided for him, and I think sometimes fate has a way of working out what's best for us all.
I am colour blind. Coffee black and white.
I've been given some amazing pieces to be able to perform over this year. We went to Palermo and we did a piece that I choreographed called Colorblind, and it was just myself and Jay dancing in it. I was given the thesis of a short passage in the Bible that I could use as a basis, and I find this piece of music that I absolutely fell in love with.
I mean, when we were in Palermo and he did this solo, and it's an amazing solo, he had young people at the stage door clamoring to get his autograph. He couldn't believe it, but they were young people who'd fallen in love with him on the stage. So that was the beginning of it. And then to go to Toronto and for everyone to say how talented he was, it just goes to show that we haven't had false hope in him. There was great interest in him from Monica Mason and the Royal Ballet, but unfortunately very, very few vacancies this year, one only, which went to a dancer who came in at the first artist category. So obviously Lee is not yet at that calibre. But I know Monica Mason has definitely followed his progress with interest and views him not only as a dancer but also as a choreographer.
Even though I've got a very good job, it will not actually deter me from my absolute goal. Everybody aspires to get to the Royal Ballet. It's just such a shame this year that they had no contracts. I mean, that's just the way things happen. Just this year, they just happened to not have any, and that's not going to stop me from coming back and trying again, because it's absolutely what I want. It's what everybody wants, and I think if you've worked as long as myself and a few of the people that have been there since the beginning of White Lodge, you know, you really will not give up on your dreams, and you'll come back and you'll keep on trying. I have absolute faith in hard work pays off. You know, I pray every night, so I have total faith that it'll happen.